depending upon the water requirement or more specifically upon the quantity of water available in their habits. The three ecologically distinct group of plants are mesophytes, hydrophytes and the third one was xerophytes. Mesophytes, that the plants growing in neither very dry nor very wet were habitat. Then hydrophytes, plants growing in or near water. Then xerophytes, plants growing in very dry habitat. But today we are going to discuss about only mesophytes. So mesophytes are found in many places such as salad forest, salad forest areas or sunny meadows or fields. Then most plants found in household gardens, parks and street and general public areas are mesophytes. Mesophytes can deal with an array of weather conditions such as humidity, dryness, moisture and wind. So now we are going to discuss about the mesophytes and various features of mesophytes. So various features of mesophytes, these are terrestrial or land plants, and the first point was these mesophytes are well developed. Well developed and extensive root system. These mesophytes are well developed and extensive root system. Then these are aerial, solid and freely branched stems. Freely branched stems. Then these mesophytes generally large, broad and thin leaves of variable shapes. Then moderately developed cuticle in aerial plants. Moderately developed cuticle in aerial parts. Then the mesophytes well developed epidermis. Well-developed epidermis without any hairy or waxy coating. Without any hairy or waxy coating. So the mesophytes are well-developed epidermis without any hairy or waxy coatings. Then the chloroplasts are present in epidermal cell. The chloroplast are present in epidermal cells. Then the stomata may be dorsiventral or isobilateral in dicots. Stomata Maybe dorsi ventral or iso bilateral in dicots, but in monocots also the stomata is dorso ventral or iso bilateral. So dicots and monocots as well, monocots as well respectively. Then the mesophyll is differentiated into palisade and spongy parenchyma. Mesophytes or the mesophyll is differentiated into palisade and spongy parenchyma. Then the vascular and mechanical tissue are well developed. The vascular and mechanical tissues are well developed. And the last, the examples of mesophytes plants are mesh, and remember it prefers moist and well-drained soils, and most crops are mesophytes. So like example, mesh, cucurbita, cucurbits, pripet, clover, and goldenrod. So basically the crops or most of the crops are belonging to the mesophytes plants. So this is all about the various features of mesophytes and the examples, some examples of mesophytes. Thank you all.